on the door.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to be sick in your bag?
Oh, no.
There you are. Anything oozing or leaking at all, is it? Hey? Should we pop you under the duvet? Shall we pop you
under the duvet? Yes, yes, anything.
We'll soon have you right as rain.
Oh, shut your face.
Now then, what I'm going to do now is gently lift you onto the bed. Now, you might experience a slight twinge. I'll just let you get some rest and then I'll come back and entertain you.
No.
I know it hurts when you laugh, so I'll be careful. Now, I had a word with the hospital, and as a bit of a treat, they've let us keep your appendix as a souvenir. I asked if they had anything else, and they gave me this spare spleen as well. That'll be your operation. They've separated you from your Siamese twin. You were joined at the bottom to Kevin Keegan. Only joking.
Oh. Gary.
Mm?
Would you like me to lie on a bit of newspaper so I can really feel like a budgie?
No. This is your activity centre. You see, at this stage in your recuperation, you're probably still feeling a little bit pathetic. So, there's a bell for my attention, grapes for nutrition, and a mirror to check you're not bleeding hideously.
What are you doing?
I've seen this on Casualty. You have to pat the head. Yes, can I help?
Can you not do that, please?
Okay, you're the boss.
Gary.
Hmm.
I really appreciate you being so kind, but I'm tired and in pain, and I suppose what I'm really saying is I want you to bugger off.
Okay.
What the farmers wanted was a smoother, more comfortable and faster...
How's Dorothy?
Fine. I'll pop back in half now, check she hasn't gone purple. You sitting close enough to that?
I'm just taking in the atmosphere in the Tomorrow's World studio. Hey, do you reckon the presenters get off with each other after the show?
Well, they always seem in a bit of a hurry to get off, don't they?
Yeah. Bought a new CD today. Kylie's latest.
Oh.
I see she's wearing glasses.
Yeah?
I think she looks really good in glasses, don't you?
Well, let's face it, Kylie looked foxy in a welder's mask with a parsnip strapped to her head. Hey, that's good, isn't it? Something to stop your tie flapping over your shoulder when you're running along. Excellent. I bet that won't hit the shops till the year 2004. I'm still waiting to buy that rubber car that makes parking so easy.
I think glasses make you look really sexy, though, don't they?
Yeah, if you think it looks sexy to have two bits of perspex and an ugly tangle of metal hanging off your face.
Well, Warren Beatty wears his quite a lot nowadays, doesn't he?
Yeah, and you're not telling me he'd have done half as much nobbing if he'd had his bins on during his major chatting up years, are you? Hello, Julie Christie. Excuse me while I pause to clean my bins on this little tiny yellow bit of cloth like a bloody librarian. Get lost, Four Eyes. Put an egg on your shoe and beat it, speckoid. Oh, a little yellow flowers wrapped in paper. How nice.
They're for Dorothy.
Oh, thanks. Did you bring any fruit?
No.
Oh, well, it's your decision.
What's the news, then?
Well, to be honest, I don't really think I've realised just how tired I am. I suppose I'm just taking things 1 hour at a time.
And Dorothy?
Oh, well, she's a bit off colour. Mind you, she just has had a rather large organ taken out of her body. Not for the first time, either.
Can I see her?
I'd rather not. She's very frail.
Oh.
You can come and sit with me and Tony. We've got a couple of lagers on the go. The chat's racy, but never oversteps the mark.
Maybe another time.
Mm.
So, how did the operation go?
Oh, very, very well. The surgeons know Dorothy of old, but I think they did a good job anyway.
I remember when I had my appendix out, it hurt so much. I thought they'd left a little burrowing animal inside.
Had they?
No.
Oh, good, good. Nice, neat scar, is it?
Yeah.
Quite low down, just above your beak.
Yes.
Yeah. Can I see it?
No.
Okay.
So can I do anything to help?
You could show me your scar.
To help Dorothy?
Oh, no, thanks. I'll shoulder the burden of caring for her.
Well, maybe later, when compassion fatigue sets in.
Well, you know me, Debs, when I set my mind to something. You haven't got any photos of your scar at all, have you?
This is Tony reading the news.
Hello, Fridge. My name is Michael Caine.
Hello. And here we have a cold front, where these letters will be coming in from here and here, making the word Schmemley. And that'll be colliding with these fridge magnets here and here.
Tony?
What?
Were you wearing glasses?
No.
Yes, you were.
What? They? Oh, no, they're not mine. No, I don't need glasses. Oh, look. Look, that pin over there. There, look, 20/20 vision.
Tony, come here. Here. There's nothing there.
How are you feeling? Do you want me to mix you up a hot poultice or something?
No, thanks. Tony, I get the impression that you're slightly embarrassed about glasses.
No, I think they're great. You know, for seeing well, if you're into that. It's just that no one in my family wears glasses. We just go straight from brilliant eyesight to dead.
You see the postcard on the mantelpiece? Read it for me.
Hi, gang. Having a great time so you can all sod off, Gary. It's from Gary.
Tony, there isn't a postcard on the mantelpiece, so throw it away.
You won't tell anybody that I wear glasses, will you?
Where are you planning to wear them? In the toilet? Alone in darkened rooms?
Please, Dotty,
don't just... call me Dotty.
Dorothy, I'm the good-looking outdoor type. I used to call the people who wore glasses specky or furniture face or short-sighty. I used to stick bubblegum on the lenses so they couldn't see properly and bumped into things.
Put them on, Tony.
I don't want to.
Tony.
I'm ashamed.
I'll tell Gary. See? I don't know what all the fuss is about. They look very nice.
I think so.
I doubt anyone would even notice. It's like people who spend their whole lives thinking they've got a big nose.
Yeah, at least I haven't got a bloody great schnoz like them.
Look, just wear the glasses and stop worrying.
I'm just a bit worried about the style, though. You don't think they make me look a bit too...
Too much like a git?
Yeah.
No, no, not at all!
Dorothy? Dorothy? Dorothy, your bed's on fire.
It's been 3 days now. Do you fancy a quickie? Nothing strenuous. You could lie on your good side, then I could just slip me old...
Gary! If you so much as touch me below the neck, I'll sue you for grievous bodily harm.
Oh, God. It's ironic, isn't it, the word patient? It's a bit like calling a mass murderer an old soppy. Oh, sorry, I'm just bored. I was really looking forward to looking after you, but you just seem so ill.
Go and play with Tony.
I can't. He's shut himself in his room.
I caught him wearing glasses this morning.
What, sunglasses?
No, real glasses.
Real glasses? Tony? But he's a normal bloke. He's never read a book in his life.
Oh, don't make fun of him. He's obviously got a complex about it.
Don't make fun of him? Are you mad? Of course I'm going to make fun of him. Peeking out from behind his glinty little windows, always getting out those nasty snappy cases.
Try and be sympathetic. I thought you two were best mates.
Yeah, well, I might have to reconsider now he's turned out to be a specky.
Hello.
Hello.
I came in last week to buy some glasses for a
friend. Yes.
Himself, you see, because he's in prison.
Prison, I remember. You realise the prescription is for your eyes, not his?
Oh, he doesn't mind. No, he only wants a vague idea of what's going on.
Did he like your choice of frame?
There is a problem. He thinks they make him look like a... git.
You haven't actually got a friend in prison, have you? Good. Should we try on some other frames?
It's all right, see, because I've cut out some glasses from a magazine. Elton John, what do you think?
I think we're still in git territory.
Emperor Hirohito, Japan.
Those are reading glasses.
Are they? Oh, I won't need them then. Bit of a long shot, though. Here. Sophia Lillard.
Oh, you like these, yeah. Stevie Wonder.
For everyday use, possibly better on a blind person?
Good point.
What image are you looking for?
Well, I want to look fashionable and intelligent and humorous and sophisticated and sexy.
Have you thought of reincarnation?
Oh, yeah.
What about contact lenses?
Oh, no, I couldn't have something up against my eye, you know, right there. Staring.
I imagine it's no more uncomfortable than wearing a condom, say.
How do you wear a condom on your eye?
No, on your penis. You might want to try and soften the shape of your face.
Soften?
By
right.
Choosing round glasses.
Oh, right, yeah, right, because actually I've got some... I've got a John Lennon here. Yeah. Shall we get with that, then?
Has he come in yet?
No.
It's just a bit of fun.
Oh, Gary, don't draw attention to him.
Relax, I won't.
Anybody want a drink?
No, thanks.
Yes, please, mate. Lager. I'll have it in one of those silly glasses.
So, Tony, how are you?
Oh, I'm great, thanks. How are you feeling, Dorothy?
Oh, better, thanks, yeah. I'm all right as long as I don't laugh.
Well, that's been a bit chilly.
Don't be so bloody immature!
Oh, go on, see him.
Mate, sorry about that just then.
It's all right.
No, it was unfair, making a spectacle of you. just joking. Put them on. They look quite good.
No way. You'll just take them, Ricky.
No, I won't.
You will.
I won't.
You will.
I won't. Put them on. Yeah, they're nice. Nice bins. How do they stay on? Have they got
a little hook on the back of the ear?
Practical. Excellent. I bet you can play football in them and everything.
Oh, yeah. As long as I don't do any sudden head movements.
Yeah. So what are you, myopic or the other one?
Yeah. Short-sighted.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm brilliant on close objects.
Yeah?
The optician said I was the best she'd ever seen on close objects.
Oh, well, that's good. And, are you going to be getting little wipers fitted?
Oh, just get out, man! You just get out!
Tea, Debs?
Yeah. Where's Tony?
I don't know. He must have joined Gary down the pub.
You know, joking aside, I really like his glasses, actually.
Yeah, I know what you mean. They're the sort of missing part of the jigsaw of his personality.
Yeah, they are.
Do you know, I think Gary is jealous.
Well, I know when I was at school, it was always the boys and glasses we went for first because they were always gentlemen.
Absolutely. I mean, even now, whenever I see a man in specs, I always get a rush of almost
Well, sexual excitement. Two. Don't go to work. I hate it here on my own.
Well, I'm sorry, Dorothy, but the business and domestic markets for high-quality security equipment don't stand still just because you claim you're feeling a little bit poorly. Where are my trousers?
I don't know.
Well, why don't you ask one of your friends over?
We all work during the day. They won't come over in the evening in case you do your usual thing of smarming up to them, calling them toots and offering them phallic-shaped nibbles.
Where are my trousers, Dorothy?
I don't know! Oh, please, Gary, please, I'll be well enough to get up in a couple of days.
You're
please.
Well enough to get up now. You could hop in a taxi and lead an expedition across the North Pole.
I'm dizzy. I'm still swollen and bleeding. I've got a temperature of over 100.
Well, you'll be nice and warm then, won't you?
How did that happen?
Give me the trousers, Dorothy!
No, look, we'll have a nice day together. We can tell each other all the things we've always wanted to tell each other, but we haven't had the time, Gary!
Go indoors somewhere else! You are driving me mad, you silly, malingering tart! I'm a bloat! I need my freedom!
Hi.
Hi.
Thanks, but I've changed my mind. I want my money back. I've decided I like it blurry.
Well, we can't do refunds.
I spent all my money. All my friends laugh at me. I've lost all the admiration and respect I've built up.
Sorry. Maybe you should overcome your doubts about contact lenses.
So... it's as comfortable as wearing a condom, yeah?
Yes.
Except you put them in your eye.
Yes.
All right.
Good. Do you have a preference between hard, gas-permeable, tinted, soft daily wear or disposable lenses?
Oh, well, you better just... give me the cheapest. No, sod it. Make it two.
Hello, love. Sorry about this morning. I don't know what came over me, as the actress said to the Dorothy. I've got you some flowers. They match your appendix. Where are you? Parents' place, all her friends, her disgusting ex-so-called boyfriends, all her favourite clothes shops.
What did they say?
They said, no, we don't appear to have a slightly deranged woman wearing pyjamas tottering derangedly through mixed separates, you stupid bastard.
Well, what could have made her run away?
I don't know. I may inadvertently have called her a malingering tart, but...
Gary, how could you?
That's the way we talk to each other. I didn't realise she'd come over all bonkers. Let's just stay calm. Try and... work out some sort of psychological profile so we can find out what she's thinking. So she's wearing ill-fitting pyjamas, right? She nearly died of a burst appendix a week earlier.
Her boyfriend's just called her a malingering
tart. So she feels let down by the one person she should be able to trust. So what's her state of mind? A little unhappy? Let's come back to that. What sort of a person is Dorothy? She's a brown-haired person. She's a scary person. She's a person with a history of volatile behaviour. But... the note she left. Look. feeling a bit odd, have gone for a walk. I mean, that sounds like someone who's actually quite sane. I don't think I need to blame myself needlessly.
She spelled odd with 5 D's.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Well, that's it. She's probably wandered onto a major road. I've killed her!
You're hysterical. Pour yourself a drink.
Oh, well, that's very clever, both of you. You've made your point. I'll take it my nursing services aren't required anymore. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. So, like, if a bloke's pain threshold, right, is up here...
Right. Where?
Here.
Oh, I can't see. It hurts when I open my eyes.
Here.
Right.
Yeah, then your average girl's is down there.
Oh, it's quite low.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. High, low. Yeah. That is the difference.
Mm.
I mean, look at the fuss women make about childbirth. Now, I'm not saying it doesn't smart a bit. But if blokes did it, I reckon you'd be looking at, well, give birth, have a couple of paracetamol, maybe a bit of a nap, and then back to work within the hour.
Yeah.
You're right there, mate.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's not a good idea to wash your contact lenses in Fuzzy Pete's shower gel, then put them back in your eyes, is it?
No.
Do you want a hand with your lager?
No, no, I'm all right, mate.
Yeah. So what's it like with your lenses in?
Oh, it's great.
Yeah?
Yeah, everything's really clear. I was walking down the street and I could see all the little leaves on the trees.
Yeah.
I could see little ants crawling along the branch. It was brilliant.
Ants? Brilliant.
Yeah. Hurts to buggery, obviously. Yeah.
So do you want to try opening your eyes again?
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah? Oh, you got my nipple!
Sorry, mate. Sorry.
Wow. You'd never know they were in.
That's the beauty of contact lenses. Yeah.
Are they comfortable?
Yeah, except when I blink.
Yeah?
So, would you look after Dorothy again, yeah?
Well, this might sound harsh, but... I think women lose a lot of their femininity when they're ill. You know what I mean? Makes them less attractive.
Still, bless them, eh?
Oh, bless them, yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers. Do you want a pickled chilli with that?
Oh, yeah.